In this video, you will learn to compute one sample t confidence intervals with raw data using StatCrunch. The data set I'm using is called Apple Juice Bottles. This data set comes from Statistics, Informed Decisions Using Data by Michael Sullivan. The apple juice column contains the amount in ounces in each of 22 bottles taken as a random sample from a manufacturer's assembly line. The filling machine is not precise, which makes the amount of juice vary from bottle to bottle. Each bottle's label states it contains 64 ounces of apple juice. The manufacturer requires that the mean amount of juice in a bottle be 64.05 ounces to decrease the chance of a bottle being under the 64-ounce threshold by random chance. Given the manufacturer's concern about filling bottles, we're going to compute a confidence interval to determine if the mean amount per bottle may be less than the target of 64.05 ounces. To do so, under the Stat menu, we'll choose T Stats, One Sample, With Data. I'll choose the Apple Juice column, and then under Perform, we'll choose Confidence Interval. By default, StatCrunch uses a value of 0.95, which will produce a 95% confidence interval for the population mean mu. For this example, I'll leave it at 0.95 and click Compute. The results show a 95% confidence interval for the mean amount in one of the manufacturer's bottles, with L limit representing the lower limit and U limit representing the upper limit of the confidence interval. StatCrunch can also store these results in the data table. To do so, under Options, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we set up our confidence interval. Under Output, I'll choose Store in Data Table. I'll click Compute. And now the results are stored in new data columns that can be used for future calculations.